Wesley McCammon, and this is my Star Trek series ranking. So in addition to Doctor Who, one of the other fandoms that I'm a part of, very proudly, by the way, is Star Trek. Yes, I'm a Trekkie and a Whovian. Trekker and a Whovian. I've enjoyed Star Trek for most of my life, and probably I started writing for Star Trek first. And so someone asked me recently in a private message to what was the order of how I would rank the Star Trek series that were on television. And so I wanted to go through really quick and make a really quick video about how I would rank the Star Trek series. For the purposes of this video, I'm not going to include the movies because they're movies, they're not television series. And I'm also not going to include the animated series because that's the original series as well. So I'm going to do the 5 live-action TV series that have been associated with the Star Trek franchise. At 5th place, the series that I would rank in that is the worst of the 5 is Star Trek Enterprise, or Enterprise. Enterprise is not a bad show. There are some good episodes. There are some good story arcs. I think it kind of jumped the shark. I wished it had been given its full 7 years like all the other series had, except for the original series, but I wished it had been given 7 seasons like Voyager and The Next Generation had and Deep Space Nine had, but, you know, it wasn't meant to be. I think they made some really fundamental mistakes in Enterprise, and I think it showed in the series. It was a pretty good step back from the original series. Although I think some of the mistakes they made were technology was too far advanced in Enterprise to be so much earlier than the original series. But you know, what can you do? You can't make it look like 1966 original series. So I would have to rank Star Trek Enterprise is my least favorite of the series. In 4th place in my Star Trek series ranking would be Star Trek Deep Space Nine. Now, I don't want you to get the idea that I don't like Star Trek Deep Space Nine, because I really do like Star Trek Deep Space Nine. The problem with Star Trek Deep Space Nine is that it wanders just a bit too far away from Gene Roddenberry's original idea of what the future would look like. It's a little too raw and a little too not utopian future that Gene Roddenberry saw in his original vision for Star Trek. Now, granted, that led for some terrific episodes. In the Pale Moonlight is an awesome episode. Another episode that I can't think of the name right off the top of my head. The Jake Sisko one, where he goes, we see Jake Sisko as an old man, and he keeps coming back and forth. I cannot remember the name of that episode. Anyway, plus the last couple of series, the last couple of seasons of Star Trek Deep Space Nine were incredible. The battles were awesome, although a little bit unrealistic. I mean, come on, one laser blast, you know, one phaser blast or a plasma cannon blast, or one disruptor blast tearing through the hull of a starship, that's just not realistic based on what we already know about the series. I mean, there should have been shield flares. Granted, it would have been much more expensive, but I mean, that's the way that we have been taught that Star Trek looks. And so that wasn't really realistic. But some of the ship techniques and the maneuvers that we saw were pretty incredible, I have to say. The last couple of seasons of Deep Space Nine were awesome. In my number 3 spot is Star Trek The Next Generation. There was a lot of speculation. I was around when Next Generation premiered and went, you know, I was alive through the whole show. And so that really was my Star Trek show. That was on during my time, you know, in my teen years. And The Next Generation was incredible. Started off kind of rocky, but I think you could really see after season 2, Star Trek The Next Generation was a success and it was its own show. I mean, Captain Picard is incredible. The cast is really, really good in The Next Generation. The writing was fantastic in The Next Generation. I mean, The Inner Light is you know, probably one of the best pieces of drama ever. And it went all the way through the end and had really good writing, even in the very last season, even up until the very last episode, was an incredible series. So The Next Generation takes my number three spot. In number two spot is Star Trek The Original Series. You just can't get any better than Star Trek The Original Series. Granted, season one and two were the best, season three not so much, but it set the stage for all of these series before. So the original series sets up the universe. And so how can you put something ahead of a show that boots the entire universe? It is the foundation which all of these other series are based on. So of course I'm going to move the original series. I mean, I really did debate whether to put Next Generation above original series or original series above Next Generation, but I think when it all comes down to it, the original series was just fantastic. So much ahead of its time in both the acting and the direction and the special effects. I mean, they were just groundbreaking at the time. I mean, the communicator, I mean, honestly, that's the cell phone. I mean, there were so many inventions that I think the original series saw and brought to life. So I think the original series has to be given credit for that. So, if you're a Star Trek fan, you know what my number one top series is. It just doesn't, for me, get any better than Star Trek Voyager. And I know some of you are going to give me a lot of hate for this because a lot of people don't like Star Trek Voyager. But out of all of the modern series, even above The Next Generation, Star Trek Voyager, to me, epitomized what the original series was all about. A crew that could not depend on Starfleet Command, that were out fighting for their lives in the vastness of space. No help from backup. No starship could come and rescue them. It was all about them, their relationship with each other, and making their way home and finding peace in this vast quadrant of space that they didn't know anything about. Voyager was, quite simply, fantastic. I mean, Captain Janeway is one of the best captains of a starship out of all of these. I mean, I know some of you probably love Captain Picard, but Captain Janeway puts him hands down the better captain. She was stern when she needed to be. She was a diplomat when she needed to be. She was a combination of Picard and Kirk all rolled into one. And I just don't think you can get a better captain than that. The dynamic was incredible. Chakotay as first officer was really good. When they brought Seven of Nine in, I mean, that was just fantastic. I mean, Seven of Nine, the ex-Borg, brought in that same feeling that Data did for The Next Generation or that Spock did for the original series. She had that person, that fish out of water story to go through. B'Elanna Torres is the chief engineer. I mean, the half Klingon, half human, dealing with her emotions and being a genius engineer at the same time. Tom Paris, the convict who didn't get along with the first officer at first, who was the pilot. The emergency medical holographic program, I mean, the EMH program was an incredible invention to begin with. Plus, it gave another dynamic to that same Data Spock dynamic there as well. And the EMH is probably one of my favorite Star Trek invention / characters ever anyway. I mean, I could just go through the whole list. Star Trek Voyager was fantastic. There were some incredible episodes of Star Trek Voyager. Also, it had one of the best games. By the way, if you've never played Star Trek Voyager Elite Force, you're missing out. It's one of the best first-person shooter games I've ever played in my life. So anyway, Star Trek Voyager, hands down, the best Star Trek show. So just to recap, Enterprise at number 5, Deep Space Nine at 4, Next Generation at 3, the original series at 2, and Star Trek Voyager is my number one favorite Star Trek series. So thanks for watching. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe for more videos. Make sure that you also leave me a comment. I love finding new YouTube channels, so make sure you leave a comment. That's how I find my favorite YouTubers. So make sure you leave a comment. I'll go check out your channel and subscribe as long as you make content. And so yeah, thanks for watching. Bye.
Name is Fanzbar, and this is...
Name's Silver. For some pesos, to please these parts.
Hey there, hello. Lovely to meet you with these eyes, although I'm not even sure what colour they are yet. What colour are my eyes?
Shut up. People have tried to shake my faith at the doctor before. It didn't work then, and it won't work now.
Well, that's it, isn't it? You've seen them do these things, haven't you? Haven't you?
Listen, I might not know what he did during this time warp, but if he's still the doctor, then I know what you're saying is wrong.
Every time the doctor changes, the same thing is bound to happen, no matter what personality he has.
Get a radar two monitors, a collection of yellow and blue cables, glitter glue, and some duct tape.
The doctor I knew was a deadly warrior.
Jenny? Jenny!
What have you done to her?
Contact established!
You know earlier, when I said it could be a horrible weapon in the wrong hands, you know what the Daleks are? The wrong hands.
Give us the device or each of you will burn!
Daleks, this is your mortal enemy, the Doctor. Exterminate him!
The Doctor is located! Exterminate! 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 Exterminate!